Yes, the Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam did not die, you know, yes. Allah says they were unable to hang or kill him. Allah stresses that twice. Allah says he was shown to them in that form. There are many verses of the Quran referring to the coming of the Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam and the great many hadith. They can be found in Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Sunan al-Nasai, and the Sunan Abu Dawud. One can clearly see them. Allah makes this clear in verse 157 of Surah An-Nisa. And they're saying, we killed the Messiah, Isa, son of Maryam, messenger of Allah. They did not kill him, and they did not crucify him, but it was made to seem so to them.
Onu öldürmediler. Ma kateluhu diyorlar.
Yes. They did not kill him and they did not crucify him, but it was made to seem so to them. In other words, Allah says that they beat the person who gave the Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam away, and since he was covered in blood and also had long hair, they imagined he was the Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam. Yes. He says, Şubbiha. Those who argue about him are in doubt about it. Yes. But Allah says he did not die. He says they have no real knowledge of it, just conjecture. In other words, Allah says the Jews were mistaken. He again emphasizes that they certainly did not kill him. He says Allah raised him up to himself. He says he raised him into the sky in a state of sleep. Allah is almighty, all wise, he says. In another verse, number 61 of Surah Az-Zukhruf, he says, he is a sign of the hour. Have no doubt about it. He says that the Prophet Jesus a.s. is a sign of doomsday. Allah says that his coming is certain. Have no doubt about it. But follow me. This is a straight path. There are also verses referring to a new world order in the time of the Prophet Jesus a.s. When Allah said, Jesus, I will take you back and raise you up to me, and purify you of those who do not believe. And I will place the people who follow you above those who do not believe until the day of rising. In other words, in a sleeping state. Because people die in their sleep, I will raise you to me in a state of sleep. And I will place the people who follow you above those who do not believe until the day of rising. And we are now abiding by the Prophet Jesus a.s. Since he is a prophet, he is also a prophet for us as Muslims. We abide by the Islam and the religion brought by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Jesus a.s. is also our prophet, and since his religion is Islam, we also abide by him. We abide by the real gospel and the real Torah actually. Allah speaks of those who follow you, meaning those Christians who converted to Islam and the entire Muslim world, will do so until the day of rising. Allah says he will place the people who follow you above those who do not believe until the day of rising, and that is world dominion. The Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam foretold beforehand. He said that one of you will betray me. He says that in the New Testament, and things happened just like he said. The Jews betrayed the Prophet Jesus to the Roman soldiers, as the region was then under Roman rule. To the best of my memory, the person who betrayed him was Judas Iscariot. There have always been traitors like him. The troops told him to enter the room where the Prophet Jesus a.s. was before them and point him out to them. They said that they would enter the room behind him. That was to catch the Prophet Jesus a.s. off his guard. So he enters the room with the soldiers behind him, but there is only one person in the chamber. In other words, the Prophet Jesus a.s. had been raised into the sky. And this person shouted out that the Prophet Jesus a.s. was not there. But the troops beat him very badly, smashing his face up. His hair was parted in the middle, and he rather resembled the Prophet Jesus. Allah says he was made to resemble him. Allah gave him more of a resemblance to the Prophet Jesus in physical appearance. And they beat him very badly and crucified him. They nailed him to the cross by his hands and feet. He died screaming the next morning and was thus terribly punished by Allah. At the end, he says, Elohi, Elohi. He addressed Allah, saying, "Why have you forsaken me?" His language is that of a hypocrite, since he himself is a hypocrite, and it appears in the Bible. After all, a prophet would never use such language. Why have you forsaken me? Because you committed evil and Allah punished you. Allah says He raised him to Him. In other words, that He placed him outside time. He was taken into the presence of Allah and will re-enter time at a later date in the same manner. When he was raised up, the Prophet Jesus ﷺ was taken with his own clothes, the clothes he was wearing at that time. He was raised in the exact state he was in at that moment. Therefore, when he returns, he will come back in that same state. He was removed outside time and will re-enter the time of this world. The time he spends outside may seem to be just a second to the Prophet Jesus ﷺ, or even less. For him, time stopped when he was removed beyond it.